Hey, thank you, I thank you, I thank you. We are the Chelsea Football Fancast, and I'm Stanford Chidge, and I've been looking forward to this part of the show for months and months and months. And the reason is...
because it's took that long to come out.
But there's a bloke called David Chidge who wrote an article. No. I mean, I seriously have, because, I mean, obviously Marco asked me to write an article for this and then told me about the idea for the book, and I just thought, this is going to be absolutely fantastic. And I've got to tell you, folks, I haven't managed to read all of it yet. It is thick. It's a book with a lot of words. Look at how thick that... never mind the quality, feel the width, as somebody famous once said. I tell you, but, you know, what I have read of it is not disappointed, and I'm so looking forward to this. So before we do that, I'm actually going to read out a little... I think there's a kind of a bit in the... I'm not stuck on pause. I'm just trying to remember what I was going to say. There's a bit in the preface which kind of sums up what this book is all about. And if I can find it, I'll read it out. Of course, I can't now, typically, but there you go. Where is it? Here we go. Well, that's how... when journalists begin their reports by... No, it's not that bit. I can't find it anyway. Let's talk about the blooming book. For goodness sake, Marco, save me, rescue me from the humongous hole I have just leapt into you head first. I mean, the first thing I want to ask you really, you know, why a book on the Roman era and when did you get the idea?
I think it was on the way home from Munich, actually. And somebody said to me, are you going to write a book about this? And I thought, you know what, there's going to be so many books about Munich and magazines. Yeah. What about something that leads up to Munich? That's when the idea...
because it's a natural closing chapter, isn't it, Munich?
Yeah, well, I mean, I kind of like thought, well, what was it now, 9 years, so 10 years. And then kind of like... I'd had the idea for the title ever since seeing the Making History, Not Reliving It flag, of yes. which there is a photograph. I've no idea if somebody out there can tell me who that flag belongs to, because I haven't seen it since Moscow, which is where the photograph of that flag was taken. That's where the idea for the title came from. And it's really annoying... a few people out there of the red-shirted persuasion.
I found the thing I wanted to read now, because it was actually where the blooming tag was stuck. I don't know why I was looking on the...
Gary did shut that out as well.
Is that why the tag...
how did he know that?
Because we can see it.
You can see it two tags.
Yeah, but I was looking at the... This sums this book up brilliantly. I will have my cake and eat it too. Right, he says, I never thought I'd live to see the... you could read it out, Marco. You
I haven't got my
words.
Glasses on.
Haven't you? Okay. But do you want to read it out? I think it would be more appropriate if
no,
you did.
No, go on, you read it.
Okay, all right.
I look like
he says, I never thought I'd live to see the day that Chelsea won the league, never mind the Champions League. Looking back over the past decade, I've been fortunate enough to see Chelsea win 11 major trophies and, in the process, visited 21 countries, making many great friendships along the way. And so for all of this, and maybe just a little bit more, I'd like to say thank you, Mr. Abramovich. Thanks to you, Chelsea have made and continue to make history. Thanks to you, every trophy that we win is one that they cannot win. Thanks to you, we can still sing songs like Have You Ever Seen Gerrard Win the League? And 8 years and you've won not very much. Hopefully 9 soon, then 10. Thanks to you, Tottenham Hotspur supporters' hopes of winning anything significant remain forlorn. Just weepy, woozy, sleepy, simple dreams. And that last fact, and I mean this from the bottom of my heart, deserves the greatest thank you of them all. And I just thought that, well, absolutely. I mean, this man can write, man, I tell you, he can write. But, you know, for me, that absolutely summed the whole ethos of it up.
Can I just say something, actually? I mean, there's a lot of things, it's my book and all this, but there are two other people involved in this, which are my great friends.
Can we mention them and talk about
Kelvin
them before
Barker
they sue us?
And He Who Cannot Be Named.